which is broken up by number 32.
Yeah, it was a great game. Kids played four quarters, played tough. We battled all the way to the end. We ran out of time, and that's just how that ended, you know. But they played tremendous. They played up tonight. They played us very tough, and I hope they win the state championship. I do.
Did the win change your thoughts of going with a field goal at the end, though?
No, you know what? He's a young, fresh, he's a sophomore kicker, and he won't put the game in his hands, so I'd like to get another first down or so, and I didn't want to put the game in his hands that far away. He never kicked a field goal that far this year, and I feel if we could get about 10 more yards, 5 more yards, they knocked it down, you know. It's part of life, you know, it's part of life. Sometimes they knock the ball down.
Did you think you'd have as many chances there to score there at the end? I mean, you guys, the interceptions they threw with the ball?
Yeah, we both rose up. I mean, we stopped them down here, they stopped us, we stopped them. That was a great game, you know. It didn't come down to one play. It really didn't. There was 12 plays in that game. Things just didn't go our way. You know, just things didn't bounce our way. But hell of a season, we couldn't be any proud of these kids.
Some things today that you guys weren't expecting. You see the short routes were there early, all game long.
Yeah, he had a quick release, and we didn't want to give up the deep ball. That was the main thing. But yeah, he was a great quarterback, one of the best we've seen. Besides him and Sean Ball were right there, the top players we've seen.
You know what? I know you scored a TD here in the game. Talk to me about that. What happened during that play?
Coach A put me in at tight end in the stack eye formation, and I hit the D end, just nudged him a little bit, and then went off in the corner route, and no one was there. Jeff threw a perfect ball.
You know, when did you guys know that you had something special going on? Was there a turning point in the season that said, hey, this is really going to be a special year?
Probably Southern Local. When we came out and beat them 48-3, we knew we had a special team right there. But we knew we had a good team from the start, but we just didn't know how. Final Four is a pretty good team.
I'm happy for our kids. You know, they worked so hard to get this. And, they just prepare so well, and they're a fun group to be around. Those kids, I wish we could play 40 more games with those kids. We wish that the seniors would never graduate. It's one of those teams. Everybody's tight-knit, everybody likes each other. You crack jokes with them, they crack jokes at each other. Everybody takes it seriously. So, this is a great group to be kids to work with, and we're happy to move on.
You know, reserved in the second half, they've stepped up their defense.
They bring you from all over the place. They blitz all over the place. And our offensive line, I think, did a great job thinking about, for the most part, what they brought at us. Because there's 7, 8, 9 guys coming on time. So, it's kind of, you hit some and you get hit some. So, it's kind of a give and take type of thing.
We talked about the pass when you were down there deep, it got intercepted.
Yep.
I think about both teams took chances here.
Yeah, we figured one more first down, game was over. They had 2 timeouts. And we came out to that play. We were successful early in the year, or earlier in the game, and they're giving me a nice play on it. A nice break on it, and what are you going to do? You know, that's our best, our quarterback's one of our best players, and that's one of our best receivers. So we're trying to put it in our best players' hands. We're trying to get one more to move on. If we complete it, we run the clock out. There's no dramatic ending at the end. So,
Casey, and Andy Hake said that both coaches would find their way. They were taking chances. You agree with that?
As an assistant at St. Paul, I've been in this situation both times where we lost in the Final Four and we went on the state championship game. And I think this game's harder because both teams are scrapping to try to get to that final game. The final game finishes either first or second. You're either state champ or state runner-up, one or the other. And this game right here is just so, there's so much emotion, there's so much heart by the kids, and they play so hard because they're trying to get to that last game to play one more time.
The playmakers you have, I mean, does that make your job as a coach easier? I mean, you can throw it, you can run it. It
makes you look a lot smarter. at this point, we got some great athletes, and so do they. They had some nice kids, too. But that's what it's all about. You know, your good kids are going to help you move on, and that's what they did tonight.
After playing these guys, how good were they? I mean, after going through 48 minutes and winning by 1 point.
I know our offensive and defensive lineman, Bryce Collins, he's out of gas. And that kid right there plays his heart out, and he just said, he goes, Coach, I don't have any more left. So if he told me, it was just a battle. It was a battle in the trenches, it was a battle all night long.
Well, he made a lot of plays.
Yeah, he's a good player. He's a good ball player.
Absolutely.
Good ball player.